Hello, this is Delight Channel. Thanks for joining me this week and thanks for being there all year long. Your presence and your views are very much appreciated. This week, we are continuing what we've been speaking about, entrepreneurship made simple. And the question for the week is, now that you have started, then what? Like I said in the last two, three videos, some are not able to take the plunge of entrepreneurship because of fear or largely because of lack of knowledge of how to proceed. The last two videos have tried to illuminate that point. But this week now, I'm saying, now that you have started, what are those things that you need to be aware of and that you need to keep your eyes on? I will run through them very quickly so that I can make it as short and succinct as possible. Number one is that you need to be aware that it will not all be rosy. You need to get that expectation sorted in your mind. No matter how beautiful the charts look, no matter how beautiful your spreadsheets look, no matter how profitable the business looks on the PC, the real world is usually a completely different ballgame. So, before you start, you need to be aware that it will not be a straight line graph. Why is this important? When you run into the bad weather, when you run into those bumps on the road, this awareness makes them less shocking, less surprising, and hopefully it gives you the strength and the courage you need to carry on. That's number one. Number two, remember that between your vision and where you are now, there is a gap that is called the development or the building phase. That big picture that you have, that nice vision that you have, is not likely to all just appear from day one. And if you have a business that you are modeling after, that is now well established, you go there, you see their offices, you see their people, you hear how much they're paying, you see their terms of employment and engagement, and you like to run like that, it's okay to have such vision, but don't be deceived that they all appear from day one. And when you are not able to do that, you begin to feel like maybe you are not performing and you begin to get discouraged. Don't allow that to happen. What am I saying? Do not despise the days of the little beginning. Remember that nothing big starts big. Usually big things start small. And usually the big things that start big, they usually do not last because they lack the required strength to grow and then become enduring. So remember that it is the direction and the vision that you are pursuing that should be most paramount in your mind, not the trappings of the immediate now, because between here and your vision, you have a lot of work to do. Next, you need to also remember that sometimes you don't have to wait for the perfect product to be ready before you hit the market. There is something called MVP in entrepreneurship. That is the minimum viable product. Meaning, what is that minimum solution that if you throw it into the market, will solve a part of the problem? It may not solve everything, but it will solve sufficiently that you attract customers, get your brand into the market, validate your ideas, and you can grow from there. So do not wait and wait and wait. And if you doubt it, go and read the story of what happened between Apple and Microsoft and how all of a sudden Microsoft eventually ended up taking over the PC market. It is because Bill Gates clearly understood the meaning of MVP. So be clear about what your MVP is, work towards it, release it, and get it going. Next is that in your journey from the beginning, and this is not easy, and I hope it helps you to pay attention to it as you start, keep records. Usually when you start, all you are worried about is, how do I get into the market? How do I get the customers? How do I service them? We usually do not pay enough attention to record keeping. I'm not saying you need to hire somebody where you can afford it, or because you want to keep record, but be deliberate. Simple tools like try as much as possible to pay all your bills from your bank account. Okay? Try as much as possible to just have a rough book, a spreadsheet. I am not asking you to turn it into a report. I'm saying just keep the records. There are people who are trained. As an example, accountants are trained to prepare your financials from what they call incomplete records. But the data must be there. So you need to keep the records. Keep your eye on, try and find creative ways of just having a tab of, somebody wants to know how much you are paying for this. If it's not in this record, it will be from the bank. As much as possible, your collections, let it go through your bank account as well. If you have all these little things in place, it is easy for you to, when you now have the space and you have the capacity, to go back to those data and then generate information from them. Next is, in the tough environment that we operate in most times, you tend to forget about the regulator, the tax man, because you are not big, because you are not known. You just carry on forgetting that the tax man will not necessarily chase you until you need him and he will double cross you. And sometimes all you need is just a letter to explain why you are not paying salaries, a letter to explain why that has not happened, or a letter just inform them that for this period we are not operating or we are not doing this. You don't need a lot of money to hire a consultant to do this for you. But do not shut your eyes to the regulatory requirement. Be aware and do your best to fulfill as much of it as you can do as you are going along, because it minimizes your exposure. Maybe you don't know, when you go foul of some of these laws, particularly the tax laws, it is not just the amount that you have not paid that is the issue. It is the penalty and the interest. By the time these things are aggregated together, they come into a very princely sum sometimes that it can derail your financials or put you under unnecessary pressure. So do your best to make sure you do not shut your eye to the regulatory or the tax side of your operations. Then next, and this is very, very fundamental, is the care and the attention that you pay to your people. Your people, those you are hiring, are your best asset. They're your most important asset. If you have taken the time to define your vision, mission, and values, and you live true to those in hiring people, do not treat them carelessly. If you find a wrong person, get rid of him or her. If you find a good person, invest in him or her. Don't treat them carelessly. And what I found is that it is not so much about how much you are able to pay. It's about how much of involvement they feel, how much of commitment to them they feel, how much of the journey you are sharing with them, how much of the journey you are promising to share with them, the little things around. Sometimes when you don't even have the money to pay salaries, are you sensitive enough to let them know why? Are you sensitive enough to help them see how they can go and come from work every day? I was speaking to one of my boys recently, who was telling me his journey about when he was unable to pay salaries in his organization. They are now much more stable. But what did he do? He organized to provide them with lunch every work day. So he may not be able to give them money to come, but the point is, when they come, they can be sure that there will be food, good food, in the office on that day. And you cannot imagine how much of difference that made to the morale of the organization. So when it comes to your people, do not treat them carelessly. Be deliberate about who you attract, about who you hire, and do your best to retain them. And if you have made recruitment error, which happens, do not stand around it and just talk. Do something. Get rid of them and build it slowly but deliberately, in ensuring that you have the people with the right attitude first, and then you can train for skills. Okay? So when you are hiring, hire first for attitude and then for skills. We will talk about this further down the line. So next is the issue of speed. In whatever you are doing, don't sit on it, don't drag your feet on it. Run as quickly as you can, because you are probably not the only one thinking about that. And if you don't move fast enough, somebody can come from somewhere and just one bullet, you are out of the market. And last but not the least is that no matter what you are doing, let continuous and never-ending improvement be your watchword. Be humble enough to ask questions. Be humble enough to accept when something is not good enough, and never settle. Never settle. Never settle. Keep pushing. You may end up even at the bus stop that is different from where you think you were heading when you started, but at least it will be in the general direction of where you are going, and it will be something better than where you started from. So never settle. Do not close your eyes, close your mind, and lose sight of what is going on around you and in the market. Keep working, keep improving, and make sure that vision that you have, you are on your way to making it happen. If you do this, then the day you decide to stop employment and move fully into this, you will not be seen as somebody who is taking a reckless risk. Even you yourself, you'll be more comfortable and confident to go after it, knowing that the building blocks are already in place. And I assure you, your boss will actually be begging you to stay on, because all of a sudden, moving from employment to entrepreneurship will not be a thing of fear for you, but you'll be walking out with full assurance. I have said a lot this week, and I hope you take time to watch and watch again as required. We will continue next week, all tracing how do you move from when you begin to stabilize, how do you handle growth. It's a big journey that we are pursuing, and I hope you stay the course, all in the name of helping you very soon to start living your dream. Share with your friends and contact. Drop us a comment, join us on Telegram, let's know you are out there. But whatever you do, don't forget to make it a date with me next week as we take the conversation forward. Thanks once again. T-Mac is still my name, and all I'm trying to do every week is what? Make a little difference. See you next week. Bye.